So good morning to all of you. We are starting with the principles of management today, the second chapter, the principles of management. Now, what are the principles of management? Management principles are statements of fundamental truth which provides guidelines for managerial decision making and action. Over the years, managers have been working in different companies. They have evolved with different experiences, and these experiences have been written down as management principles which help the later managers. They are just guidelines. They are guidelines for any decision making that the manager is doing in a company. Now, what are the nature of management principles? There are seven nature of management principles that we will be doing. Universal application, general guidelines formed by practice and experimentation, flexible, mainly behavioral, cause and effect relationship, and the last one is contingent. So let us see the first one, that is universal application. Management principles can be applied to all kinds of organizations. Throughout the world, we have different kinds of organizations, small, big, business organization, government organization, social organizations. So it is applicable in any type of organization. However, how you will apply these principles will vary from organization to organization. Next one is general guidelines. Management principles are not ready-made solution to your problem. They are just general guidelines. These have to be adjusted as per the demand, as per the situations. Principles should be applied in accordance with the need of the organization. Now, the organization environment, or the country's environment, whichever the organization is in, differs from place to place. The environment is different, therefore these are just guidelines. They have to be adjusted according to the situation or the environment your organization is in. So these are general guidelines. They are not a legitimate solution. They have to be improvised upon. Next, formed by practice and experience. As I told you that these are principles which have been evolved by managers over years of practice, over years of experience, over years of observation. So the principles have been evolved through observation, experience and experience of management thinkers. Next, when we talk about an example here, discipline. Discipline has been one of the observation of the managers. Now, what is the observation telling? It tells that discipline is crucial for all the organization. If you want organized work, you need to be disciplined. So how did we know about this? Over the years, managers have found out that discipline is important. So therefore, observation, experimentation and experience is a must for these principles that have been evolved. Next is flexible. Management principles are not rigid. They cannot be rigid like pure science principles. Pure science principles, if I talk about Newton's law, it is all the same everywhere throughout the world. But when we talk about principles of management, they can be modified as per the circumstances or the environment. Next is mainly behavioral. Now, managers are dealing with human beings with different nature, behavior. Their behavior is complex. Each day a person cannot be the same. His behavior keeps on changing. Not only that, person to person behavior changes. So understanding the behavior of the people, predicting the human behavior, is what principles show us help us to understand. Next is cause and effect relationship. Management principles are based on cause and effect relationship. If a certain thing happens, cause, what will be the effect? Like if I say unity of command happens in an organization, so what will be the effect? It will avoid confusion. So, principle of unity of command is the cause, and what is the effect? Avoids confusion. So, it tries to establish cause and effect relationship. Next is contingent. This is the last nature of principles of management. What do you mean by contingent? Contingent mainly means depends on. So, management principle depends on prevailing circumstances at a point of time. Like today when we are facing with coronavirus, if I say the principle of fair remuneration, what was applied before this situation, will it apply in the same situation? No, it will depend on the present condition. So fair wages today will depend upon multiple factors such as paying capacity of the person, contribution of the employees, prevailing wage rates. Wage rates, you know, differs from country to country, place to place. So therefore we say the principles of management or management principles are contingent. That is, they depend on a particular situation, the prevailing situation. So thank you, hope you have understood the nature of management principles.